joy in Berlin today, and with good reason. For the blockade imposed by Russia, which virtually isolated the western section of the city, has been lifted. All along a thousand-mile front, preparations for the new order of things go forward feverishly. As the 0 hour nears, trucks from American and British zones are lined up along the road, ready to make their dash to the capital, their first run in almost a year. As ground traffic begins to flow, long idle engines get warmed up. During the first 24 hours after the blockade lifting, 13 trains enter the city, bringing badly needed coal. As commerce is resumed, German workers tear down roadblocks and repair streets that were torn up during the Cold War. As traffic begins to roll again, streets long unused are cleared of rubble. This is the day for barriers to fall, and more than material barriers are removed as German and Russian police shake hands. A steady stream of trucks seek to build Berlin's stockpiles against any future blockade or the breakdown of the foreign minister's negotiations in Paris. With a free road into Berlin and coal flowing in, power is restored to the western sectors, which had existed in a partial blackout for the past year. A hearty welcome awaits the first supplies to arrive by land. General Frank Howley, sector commandant of Berlin, gives his views of the historic bluff that failed.
It doesn't mean the end of Berlin's problems. We had quite a few problems before this last masterpiece was thought of. However, it is the hope of everyone that it not only marks a discontinuance of the brutal blockade, but that it also means a change in spirit on the part of our great wartime ally. We hope that this will lead to a change of spirit which will make it possible for us to get along in harmony. I hope that they, as others have learned, that the use of force against the United States, Great Britain, and France is not a practical or successful instrument of foreign policy. I hope that the communists who have spent so much time insulting us will realize that we really aren't such a soft democracy.
But the airlift, trump card, which broke the back of the blockade by delivering 1.5 million tons of supplies, roars on, ready should diplomacy fail.